itong mga hiwagang kamay ni Rico ang gumawa niya.
If you're Filipino, you'll agree when I say that lechon is life. And if you're a foodie, you'll also agree when I say that not all lechons are made equal. We all have our favorites. Mine happens to be this version from Cebu.
Rico's lechon is a must try in Cebu. This is the best Cebu lechon, especially when it's freshly made. So I got the idea from his ingredients and I made a version of boneless Cebu lechon. Try this.
In this easy recipe, we're going to take some lean pork belly, which we will stuff full of bay leaves, garlic, red onions, tomatoes, lemongrass, and spring onions. Tie in all those flavors with salt, peppercorn, sili, and patis, and we're all set to roast our lechon to perfection. And what's the oil doing here, you ask? That's a crispy secret I'll be sharing with you later on. While I preheat the oven at 350 degrees, I also call in reinforcements to help me cook and eat the lechon.
My favorite eldest boy is here, si Franco.
Hi, guys.
Alam mo, Franks, every time you mention Cebu and you talk about their food, the first thing that jumps out to you is Cebu lechon, di ba?
Correct.
Okay, now, in recent years, they've come up with a boneless lechon belly. Mm. Okay? So, yun ang gagawin natin. This is how we will start this, no? Let's get a blender muna, Franks.
Blender?
Yes.
Okay.
Yan, or yung food processor. We're going to put in lemongrass. This is yung tender part of the lemongrass.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Tapos, let's put in our...
Chili.
Sili. Oh, papalunok ko rito, eh, no? Siling labuyo. Meron kang konting bay leaf. Okay. We have some red onions. Okay. We have some...
Tomatoes.
Garlic, okay. The whole peppercorns,
okay,
and some salt. It only takes 10 seconds to whip this up in a food processor. If you don't have one, that's okay. Just chop everything finely and mix together. Naamoy mo, you smell that?
Yep.
Okay.
Parang I smell the lemongrass.
Yeah. Those are the things that we want to stand out. Can you smell the siling labuyo also?
I do, actually. Diba? Yep.
So, what we will do here in our pan is we are going to put some lemongrass as the bed para may konting aroma rin yan, di ba? Bento ko lang yan. So, what we will do here is we are going to brush this. Brush it with patis, Franks.
Okay. Why patis, Pop?
Instead of salt, kasi patis is very flavorful also eh. Now, you wanna put some pepper in this, Franks?
Yeah.
Now, teka muna, I want to mention this, no? When you roll it, it has to be like this, no? So, you see the meat running this way.
Right.
Yung meat, we roll it this way.
Okay.
Now, you want to put the middle na?
Sure.
Yung ano natin.
Do I just put all of it?
Yes.
Okay.
Lagyan mo. Okay.
Massage in all those flavors. Add some spring onions for good measure. Roll tightly. And secure your masterpiece by tying it up with some kitchen string.
So yan, I tied the knot, no?
Okay.
Gagawin natin is we'll put this here and then start tying it na. Kaganoon mo lang siya, yun. Tapos make sure that it's tight para may parang pressure cooker effect inside, di ba?
Mm-hmm.
So that it's nice and tender. And then what do you have to do next, Franks? Do we just put it like this, unflavored?
Would you baste it again with patis?
Good idea.
Galing naman ito man ako.
Oh.
A final coat of patis and pepper and our lechon is finally headed to the oven.
Now, we put this here, lay it on a bed of lemongrass,
mm-hmm.
and we bake this siguro mga 2-3 hours. 350 degrees.
Nice.
What do you think?
I like it.
Boom.
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 After 2-3 hours in the oven, this little piggy finally went to flavorful, crispy, golden brown heaven.
Wow. Nakakatuwa, no?
What do you think?
Salap.
Yep, no. Yun na.
Boom.
Cebu lechon.
But wait! If crazy crispy lechon is what you're going for, you're gonna want to hear my next tip.
You know what we'll do here? We'll make it rest for a while, and then we'll fry just the skin to make it even more crispy. Listen to this. Diba?
Frying the skin for an extra 10 minutes is such a simple step, but trust me, it can add so much more texture to your lechon. And there it is, the crispiest, juiciest, most satisfying boneless lechon you can ever make at home. Sira na naman ang diet ni Franco.
Oh, see? You can hear the crunch, no? Okay, so slice tayo.
Manila people like to enjoy this with lechon sauce, but in Cebu, vinegar is the name of the game. Next time, try eating lechon with their dipping sauce of garlic, onions, siling labuyo, and vinegar.
Okay,
wrap. You know, there's a big difference from the first test without the frying.
Uh-oh.
But if you take the extra step to fry the outside,
sarap ano?
Laking difference.
So this is the one I'm telling you about. Yung parang upping the standard by improving the texture, not necessarily the taste, di ba?
Correct.
Galing. Very nice.
Like, he always surprises me to this day. Every dish, he always surprises me, which is what I think makes him so successful, because his food's not monotonous. Even though his dishes are very simple, the element of surprise, I think, is very, very important to why his dishes are so amazing.
You know, boneless Cebu lechon. Delicious, no?
Delicious. Mm.